Good morning po.
Maganda, yes sir. Magandang umaga po sa inyo. Ano po ang reaksyon niyo sa pahayag ni Pangulong Duterte given that in some parts of the speech, he did address you personally and asked you to help him that even as the military fights against terrorism, that you start talking about peace already?
It has always been the policy of the president to be talking. You know, he has always said that there's really nothing good for either side if we continue on fighting. So, Tucky was mentioning about the awards that he has been giving to mga sundalo, that this award is Lapu-Lapu. Lapu-Lapu, ang Lapu-Lapu award, sabi niya, ay yan ay isang tausog na napunta sa Cebu. So, there shouldn't be any reason really if you, sabi niya, kung titingnan ninyo, na magtaroon baka magkahawig ang salita ng tausog at saka Bisaya.
Oo. All right. Okay. So, Governor, was martial law discussed at any point of the speech? Because the speech clearly was aired later, so we don't know if it's been edited. Did the president discuss martial law during the live speech?
There was no mention about martial law because he already knows that martial law wouldn't really solve the problem here, and he wouldn't. I mean, I wouldn't think that the president would declare martial law in one province like Sulu, unlike in the past when there was a siege in Marawi. He declared martial law not only in Marawi but in the entire region of Mindanao.
So what kind of security measures have been put in place in Holosolu now to ensure that this will not happen again?
Of course, we will tighten the enforcement of the yung mga protocols and guidelines on the COVID-19, in which case we should be able to easily identify individuals. We are already enforcing it, we are implementing whatever protocols and guidelines that we have at the moment, but just a matter of really strictly, in which case we will be preventing the spread of COVID, and at the same time, should be able to identify and distinguish the good from the bad.
Okay, when you say Governor tighten protocols, can you be specific? For example, how would you do that? Tightening protocols, will you be, for example, checking every vehicle that comes into the city? Ano specifically ang gagawin po nyo para mas mahigpit
example,
ang protocols?
About vehicles, we will strictly enforce the matter of yung distancing on vehicles, in which cases it will be much easier for identification.
Okay.
And then, as well as we will, alisin natin ang mask for a while. And do not wear dark glasses with caps.
Paulit po. Para lang. So, bawal ang magsuot ng salamin with caps? Isa yon?
It's a checkpoint.
Sa checkpoint.
You can, of course you can.
Okay.
You can wear them. Or you can wear your cap, you can wear your glasses, but the checkpoints, can you remove them for a short while together with the mask?
Okay. Eh pagdating po sabi niyo yung mask, pakiulit yung sinabi niyo Governor sa mask.
Yung sa mask, ibababa din na muna.
Okay. Ngayon, naniniwala po ba kayo because there are now conflicting reports while the police and the military investigations in preliminary investigations, they believe that the suicide bombers were female. Another expert coming from Mindanao doesn't believe that the two suicide bombers were female. Ang una kong tanong, may natanggap na kayong bagong investigasyon ba tungkol dito? At ano po ang pinaniniwalaan po ninyo?
Initially, according to the investigators, the local investigators, it was some kind of a roadside bomb put on a motorbike. But then, as I discussed this with Secretary Lorenzana, Secretary Lorenzana was telling me, how could it be that motorcycle, when I saw the picture, that the motorcycle is still there standing on the side that it was parked.
Mm-mm.
If it were a motorcycle, you wouldn't see the motorcycle on that same place. Sabi ko, mukhang tama si Secretary Lorenzana sa investigation. But anyway, I received a text message from the NBI.
Oh.
That there is a team now investigating further.
Mm-mm.
They want to go deeper.
Mm-mm.
That's why we did not touch the site.
Mm-mm.
Oh, even when we were there at the site, blast site yesterday with the president, everything is still there.
Ba-a.
Nothing is touched, and it is called on.
Okay. Now, Senator Risa Ontiveros is calling on PNP Chief Archie Gamboa that the nine police officers in Jolo who were responsible for shooting and killing four Army soldiers last June be suspended, as General Vinluan during the hearing said it is possible that the nine Jolo PNP officials may have links or could be related to these two suicide bombers. Do you agree that the PNP Jolo should be suspended or relieved already?
Well, the matter of suspending them should not even be discussed. In the first place, it is not only suspending the whole police a unit in this station, who will do the policing of the town?
Mm-hmm. No, but relieving just the nine. The nine involved.
The nine. Well, it is an administrative matter that we should leave it to the authorities of the police. Leave it to the higher headquarters of the Philippine National Police. And besides, the matter is already being investigated. I think the cases have already been filed. So I would rather that we don't discuss it and leave it to the court.
Yes, but does it bother you or disturb you that General Vinluan has brought up a possibility that if the nine police officers are related somewhat to the suicide bombers, that would make them in effect, they've co-opted to a terrorist attack. It would come to that. You still trust them to be in power?
I still believe that we should leave that to the court to investigate. I would rather not make any comment on that.
Okay. Now, General Vinluan, when I last interviewed him, said that what's important is to give an economic package somewhat to the people of Jolo Sulu. Being the governor, and of course the effect of COVID and the blast, would you need or have you asked President Duterte for an additional economic package, Governor?
More. For whom?
For the city.
Well, the president has been providing, but I think there is, I have discussed this with Secretary Lorenzana, Secretary, since Lorenzana is the cabinet officer for regional development and security for the whole of BARC. I have discussed about the matter of the manner of governing by the BARM regional government. Because up to now, they have not appointed not a single personnel to any positions in practically all of departments because they say that by law, these positions will have to be vacated. Mm-mm. The positions in the different line agencies of government, except for health, education, and social services. All the rest, all employees will have to go. So unless they are rehired. But up to now, they have not hired or rehired anyone. So how can they govern?
Mm-mm.
I mean, it's not just a matter of providing the economic package. Who will manage these offices?
Yeah. How many people are we talking about?
We're talking of practically all offices, all departments, except the three departments, social services, health, and education. All the rest, department, there are personnel in those offices, they're only skeletal and caretakers.
Mm-mm.
Like, hit me up on you only had the caretaker, the OICG, officer in charge, like the district engineer. But the district engineer is only with, 5, 6, 7 personnel to be handling the whole office.
Mm-mm.
But this has been for more than a year already. They have been there for more than a year. So we cannot be waiting forever.
Oo. So clearly you are calling.
We already discussed this before the president in the presence of the farm officials, including Chairman Murad, was already invited to Malacañang. And I brought this up before the president about, like, why don't you convene the Council of Leaders? The Council of Leaders will be constituted by the 5 governors in the armed provinces and some members of the parliament. And of course, to be chaired by the by Chairman Murad. But after all, we have not convened. I mean, COVID has always been a good excuse.
Yeah. So you are calling for all these positions in BARM to be filled up. And in effect, you are calling because this is what essentially would make the autonomy in the region on the ground essentially work.
Of course, even if we had the money, if nobody would implement, how are we going to do it?
Mm-mm.
And we have a lot of money in the BARM from the national government and from Congress. Like, you know, there is this, they call block grant. Grant in the amounting to several billions of pesos. But the question there is, what have we done with the...
With a grant.
That amount of money.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Governor Abdur Sakurtan, for taking our call this morning. And I think you've made your position quite clear. Thank you, sir.